Digital Trainee. Today's topic is how to live your own website on WordPress through cPanel. So these are the step-by-step process I'm going to tell you to live your own website. If you don't have website, then you can't able to create your digital marketing strategy. So if you want to make your brand online, so website is very essential things, right? So live your website by using this free tutorial. So just follow this step-by-step guide and live your own website. So first step is you have to buy a domain name and hosting from hosting provider in India like GoDaddy, HostGator, Bluehost. So there are lots of hosting provider in India. So you just need to buy it from that. Like a second step, you just need to log in. So after the buying, get a username and password like this. So this is your URL, this is your username, and this is your password. So you just need to go to that username. Go to that URL and put your username. So this is my username. I'm copying it and just paste here. And this is my password. So I'm going here and it's my password. So I'm just logging to my cPanel. So this is my cPanel. There are various sections in the cPanel like file section, database section, domain section, email section, matrices, and there are lots of sections in that. So then we need to go to the file manager section. So go to the file manager section. And then public.html. So all the data of your website is into the file manager section. So here you find nothing. So just delete all this data. Your directory is empty. So next step is, so download WordPress. Go to the wordpress.org. .org. And download WordPress from here. Just download WordPress and just download it. So downloading has started, you can see here. Okay, so then again go to your cPanel and upload. You can see the upload. So just select the file and so this is my folder. So just upload the WordPress folder. So uploading has started. Just wait for the upload. Yes, uploading is done. So let's go to back. So you can see you are successfully uploaded our downloaded WordPress file in your cPanel. So just extract it. This is zip file. You must have to extract. So after the extractions, so you'll see the folder. So I don't want all the data in that folder. So all this file, just move it to your public.html. So I'm moving all this file into. So you have successfully uploaded all this data, WordPress data, in your website. So then next stage is go after the upload, then go to the your site. My site is bloggerhunt.com. So you'll see the step by step process. You'll see the process. So just select your language, then let's go. So you need database name, username, password. So again, after you have to create user database and username and password, then you can go to the MySQL database, create database, right? So just give the name, let's say Sean. So I have given ERSH Prashant is my database UN. Just click on the create user. So you have created the database name. So just note down the database name. So database name will be my this blogger stunt address underscore Prashant is my username. So again go back and again you need to create user. So follow you, if you see the user, so you need username and password. So this is your, you can create username. So this is my username, let's say Prashant is my username, and password, you can click on the password you have generated and just click on, just copy this and paste here. So you can see, so let's again create password, just copy, paste and create user. So you have successfully created username, database name and password. So you can see here a database name is this, and you can see here a username. So this is the username, you can see. So this is username, right? So this is my username and the password that I have created. So what was that password? I forgot it actually. So just change password again, password generated. So this is my password. So I'll create, so change password, okay, and then this is your password, right? So this is how you have created username, database name, username, password. Just after this process, you must add, here you can see add user to database. So this is my username, right? Blogger stunt Prashant, and my database name. So you must have to add this, because if you forget to do this, your process will not go forward. So just give all the permission, click all these things and make changes. So you are successfully done with this stage. So again, go to your installation process. So what was my username? So this is my username, and this is my database name, and this is my username, and this is my password, okay? So and don't change this and submit, okay? So you have successfully done this and run the install. So you will see here you need site title and username and password. So this is your website title. So just give my personal blog, and my username is Prashant, like that. So this is Prashant, and your email ID, just give your email ID. Yes. So this is my email ID, let's say, and install WordPress. So you have successfully installed WordPress on your website. So if you check, so your website is live right now. You can see your website is live. So how to make your website, how to design your website, so we will see in the next video. So hope you understand all these steps. Just follow the step by step process and live your website. So you don't need coding. In the next video, I am going to tell you how to design it properly. So thank you very much. Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, just subscribe our channel and comment if you still have some doubt in that. So we'll definitely clarify it. So thank you very much.